Well, that one's a classic for a reason. That's a good song. That is Money, That's What I Want by Barrett Strong from 1959. From his 1959 single of the same name. This was actually written by Berry Gordy and Janie Bradford, and was their first hit record for Gordy's Motown Enterprise at the time. Pretty cool song. It looks like it was actually kind of just a spontaneous recording dashing down at the Hitsville Studio A in Detroit, according to Wikipedia.com. We're listening to that today because we are doing a Beatles tournament, and basically, or and the Beatles covered this song, and that we'll be listening to it today as part of the tournament. Hi, my name is Bean, and you're watching Battle of the Band. We're on day 64 of the Beatles tournament. And I think that means we've made it through the halfway point of the first round. So that's cool, right? We should cheer here. So this is the beginning of the second half of the tournament. Oh no. So we're at the halfway point of round one in the Beatles tournament. This is the beginning of the second half of the first round of the Beatles tournament. So we've listened to a full half of the Beatles songs in reverse, with some distortion, and we're about to hear the rest of them too. If you're unfamiliar with the tournament, basically what it is we took every single Beatles track, studio track, including the Quarrymen, and we threw them into a single elimination style tournament to decide which one would be the best song standing in the end. Today we have two songs from the first half of the 60s going up against each other. Well, barely the first half. One of them is 1965, but we'll consider that the first half. First up will be Michelle, which is track 7 off of Rubber Soul from 1965. Genius.com says that this one was inspired by a comical faux French ballad he used to busk in the streets when he was a teenager in order to attract women and make his friends laugh. This is based on a little funny, like, fake French song that he made up. And I remember it kind of. I'm gonna have to listen to it again, though. We'll see what it sounds like. And then, of course, we'll know what it sounds like while walking through the halls of hell, because that's what we do on this channel. We play them backwards, distorted. I want the Beatles to sound as unsettling as possible. And that's going up against Money, That's What I Want from a couple years earlier. This is off of 1963's With the Beatles, track 14. I think this might be the third or fourth day in a row we've done something off of With the Beatles. We've been getting a lot of With the Beatles lately. I guess if this is track 14, it's the last track. There's just a lot of tracks on this album, I guess. And this is a cover, of course, of a Barrett Strong song of the same name, Money, That's What I Want. It does mention on Genius.com that part of the irony of this classic song is that Strong was ultimately screwed out of his royalties from the tune's success, and apparently Berry Gordy made all the money, which is really sadly common in Motown. Like, the artists didn't really make all that much money compared to the record industry. They really cleaned up on Motown. I'd like to get into that at some point because I only have like a passing knowledge of Motown in America, and I really enjoy most of the songs that I've heard. I just don't know a lot about the history, so I should look into that a bit more because I know it's very interesting history. So that's going to be the Beatles song we're going to be listening to today. That's a weird way to say it. But we'll be listening to the Beatles version backwards and distorted. So I hope you enjoyed listening to it forward in the intro. I do link the songs down below so you can listen to them however you want to. You can listen to them in this video, you can listen to them normally, whatever you want to decide what's the best Beatles song out there. With all that said, let's just get right on into it. First up, we have Michelle by the Beatles.
No.
Really like that bass solo at the end. It's nothing too special there, but nothing bad either. That's actually I like that song a lot. I definitely remember it once it started playing, it popped right into my head. The I love you, I love you, I love you. Kind of a callback to their older their older like love song obsession. Like they didn't really write as many love songs later on. And this one felt like it was a kind of poking fun at them a little bit for that. Like that older feel they used to have. This is an older song coming up next, though, and it's not a love song at all. In fact, it mentions that the birds and bees are free, and that's all that needs to be free, because I don't want money. Let's get going with it. Here is Money, That's What I Want.
Thank you.
All right, that is a very solid cover. Doesn't do a whole lot different from the original, but definitely does it the way the Beatles should do it. John's voice was really strong on that one. I really like the outro, especially like the part where he says, "I want to be free." He does really well there. You can tell he means it. Sorry, I didn't mention I have this terrible cold, so I sound horrible. I hope you all enjoy that. Super fun. All right, so I think Money, That's What I Want is actually probably a better song out of the two, but it's not an original. And if you've been watching this channel for any amount of time, you know that when it comes down to me being kind of on the fence about something, the original is usually the one that goes through. And I think that's going to be the case today. Like, that was a really solid cover of Money, That's What I Want. I love the piano. The vocals were spot on. Super great cover. But they didn't write it. And also, they didn't write it, but they also, you know, I bet Barrett Strong didn't make any money off of the Beatles covering it. And I'm sure the Beatles made a lot of money off of the Beatles covering it comparatively. So, you know, that's kind of like the Motown thing, I guess. Like, you just got screwed over by record industries or managers. Like, that was just the way it was in Motown. You just got screwed over. You made great music and you got screwed over. Kind of reminds me of, like the blues music in the early, like in the 30s, like early 21st century. Like, in the early 20th century. Geez, almost 100 years ago, there's just, like, so much good blues that got recorded, but you don't know anything about the artists or anything. It's just a bunch of obscure stuff that someone with a record company recorded, you know, and probably profited off of, where the artist just faded into obscurity. They got paid, you know, a quick buck for the tunes, and that was about it. All right. All that is very important to say, but the most important thing to say is that I think Michelle wins for the day. It's a really sweet little song, kind of like a love song spoof. It really does sound like one. I looked up the French lyrics here, and apparently it's French for, are words that go very well together, very well together. So, like, Michelle, ma belle, those are words that go well together, and then I need you, and it's just kind of like they're making fun of their own lyrics here, and I kind of like that. It's pretty fun. So yeah. That's going to move on to the next round. I hope you're all locked in and ready for the second half of the first round of the Beatles tournament. Because once we get through with this first round, it's going to be smooth sailing from here. Actually, with a tournament this long, sometimes the second round's a slog too. We'll see. We've got social media we can hang out on in the meantime. There's Instagram, there's Facebook, and there's Twitter. We do have polling systems set up on Instagram and Twitter, so you can vote for your favorite songs there if you'd like to. I link the videos down below, like I said, so you can listen to them in the proper fashion rather than through the gates of hell, which is the fashion I prefer to listen to them. I'll also link that Barrett Strong song down below so you can listen to the original version of Money, That's What I Want. And there's a lot of versions of Money, That's What I Want. That's a fun song. There's a lot of different versions out there. And there are a lot of different versions out there, and I really like them. Most of the ones I've heard anyway. Like this video if you like this video. Subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more content like this. We are running a Butthole Surfers tournament at the same time, so if that sounds like something you'd be into, you should check those videos out too. Share this video with your friends and family and neighbors. Share it with your enemies. Share it with your dog. Share it with a parrot. That one rhymed. You know, also I'd need you guys to comment down below. I get a lot of comments and I love them. I'll answer, like, just about everything you have to say. Some things I won't answer. It's fun to find out what I will talk about. I pretty much answer every comment down there. So let me know which song you would have chosen down there. And let me know how you're doing today. Let me know how the smells are, Ben. I'll see y'all tomorrow for another Beatles video and another Butthole Surfers video. I'm going to go take some cold meds. Hope you all have a great night, wonderful afternoon, and a fantastic morning. I'll see y'all tomorrow. kind of. No. We are listening to that. Oh, and we're on day 50, 60. I want money.